This is a backflow incense burner. Instead of burning incense sticks, it burns incense cones, and through some combination of geometry and fluid dynamics, the smoke falls instead of rises. It's a smoke waterfall, or a smoke fall. A number of things confuse me about this. Like, smoke rises, it doesn't fall. Actually, I think I've figured out how smoke can fall, but there is still something that confuses me here. You can see that there's a hole in the bottom of the incense cone, and if we cut the thing in half, you can see the hole reaches to about this height. So as the incense burns down, eventually the leading edge of the fire reaches the hole. And when it does, the smoke from the fire is able to escape into this cavity. And because the smoke isn't immediately carried up and away by convection, it has a chance to cool down. Smoke is made up of tiny solid particles, which are, of course, heavier than air. So if they are given a chance to cool down, we should expect them to fall. In fact, our intuition about smoke rising is based on confounding circumstance. Like, when we see smoke in our everyday lives, those smoke particles are typically suspended in hot gas because they've just come from a fire. Hot gas expands, which makes it less dense, which causes it to rise. And when it does, it will take those suspended smoke particles with it. Two things surprise me, though. The first is, why is so much smoke coming out the bottom and almost no smoke coming out the top? The way an incense cone burns is similar to a forest fire. You've got the burnt parts, the unburnt parts, and a line of fire in between. That line of fire is pumping out hot gas and smoke in every direction. So we should expect smoke to come out the top and the bottom of the incense cone. And if anything, we should expect more smoke to come out of the top, because the bottom side of the fire is mostly blocked by solid fuel, with just a little gap in the middle, whereas the top side of the fire is exposed to a very porous layer of ash. The answer, I think, is that actually a lot of smoke is coming out of the top. It's just moving much faster because of convection, so it's harder to see. Or more formally, you could say that for a fixed smoke flux, if the stream of smoke is moving faster, then it must be less dense. So the smoke is coming out of the top, it's just harder to see. It's also worth noting that incense material is quite porous. Like, if I suck on the end of this incense cone, I can suck air through the material itself. That means that gases expanding out from the fire line can be pushed through the unburnt material and reach the cavity. By the way, incense is an example of an excitable medium. An excitable medium is a medium that some kind of wave can pass through, like the fire passing through the incense like a wave, but it can only pass through once because the medium is spent by the wave. A forest fire is another example. A Mexican wave is an example as well. After a spectator takes part in a Mexican wave, it's unlikely that they would accept a second wave in a short time period. But if enough time passes, a second wave is possible. And that time period is called the refractory time of the excitable medium. In the case of people at a sporting event, the refractory time is usually short enough that a Mexican wave can just keep going round and round in a stadium. My favorite example of an excitable medium is bubbles on the surface of a drink, like hot chocolate. If one bubble bursts, that reduces the stability of the bubbles surrounding it, so they burst, and then the neighbor's bubbles burst, and so on and so on. A number of people have sent me examples of this, actually, which I'm very grateful for, and I'm grateful to be able to include one in a video. This one from Ryan Cummings shows the effect with pomegranate juice. Did you know I do regular live Q&As for my Patreon supporters? Yeah, and I've just added a Discord server that you're automatically added to when you become a supporter on Patreon. Yes, I will be using the Discord server's voice channel during Q&As so that supporters can get involved in the discussion. Hello? Sorry, it's a really bad line. Link to my Patreon page in the card and the description there. One thing I'm not totally sure about is the role geometry plays in smoke falls. Like, I thought it'd be really cool to have smoke falling from between my fingers, so I set up this little copper tube that I could pinch between my fingers and have the smoke fall from beneath, but it just didn't work. The smoke just goes off to the side, and actually, if I just hold the incense like this, it floats upwards. My first thought was that perhaps the copper tube doesn't provide enough cooling. Like if you look at this burner, there's a big chunk of metal there. That's probably a really good heat sink. But actually, if you lift the lid off, the same thing happens. The smoke floats out to the side and then rises up. So I think the real issue here is not that the smoke couldn't cool down enough, but it's an issue of convection. This thing's pumping out quite a lot of heat. So I imagine there must be convection currents pulling the air upwards from below, destroying the smoke fall. The glass surround of this backflow burner does a good job of blocking out convection currents. And in fact, I can get a nice smoke fall from between my fingers if I put my hand in this display case. What's interesting though is that you can set up a smoke fall in another way that's quite straightforward. Take a post-it note, roll it up into something about the thickness of a pencil. You can use the sticky edge of the post-it note to keep it rolled up. You then create a little stand to hold the post-it note at an angle, and you light the top end. And look, there's a smoke fall. But to me, it looks like there's nothing in the geometry to prevent convection currents. Perhaps it's the angle that helps. Like maybe the fire is far enough away from the smoke fall that it doesn't disturb it. Testing an incense cone with a bent copper pipe seems to confirm that. I also think it's just a good idea to isolate the stream from general gusts in the room. The other thing that I realized I didn't understand as I was investigating this video is the difference between a smoldering fire and a flaming fire. Like, why doesn't an incense stick have a flame? And well, it turns out that actually the flame is the special case and the smolder is just an ordinary fire. It's a solid fuel interacting with oxygen in the air. And of course, that will happen at the surface of the fuel, that's smoldering. But if the fuel contains enough volatile compounds, then when it heats up and releases those volatile compounds, assuming they're combustible, then they will burn in the air and you will see that as a flame. So the reason incense burns without a flame is that when the fuel gets hot, it doesn't release enough combustible material to create a sustained reaction with oxygen in the air. One final thing that I think needs to be explained is, like, in the case of the rolled up post-it note, I would expect the hot air rising from the lit end to suck air up through the tube and so kill the smoke fall at the other end, but it doesn't. I suspect it's because the creation of hot expanding gases in the fire is more than enough to counterbalance convection, acting to pull up through the tube. But either way, these backflow incense burners look really cool. And by the way, thanks to Vivek Patak for the idea for this video. I've been getting KiwiCo crates for my kids for over a year now, so it's great to have them as a regular sponsor on the channel. KiwiCo put together these projects. They come in the post once a month and everything you need for the project is there in the box. You don't have to rush out to the shops or anything like that. They have 9 different subscription lines for every possible age group. For me, I get these crates because I love to see my kids getting excited about making and building stuff. Like, those are my fondest memories from childhood. And I feel like my kids have got a really positive association with STEM learning now. Each STEM project receives over 1,000 hours of development before it reaches you, including testing with kids. You can really see it in the details. Like, maybe you're building an articulated lamp, but you're also learning about levers and pulleys along the way. Or maybe you're building a solar system mobile, but you're also learning about weights and balances. There's a lot of replay value in these projects as well. You don't just make them and then put them away and never see them again. Like, some of these projects, my kids are still playing with months later. You don't actually have to subscribe. You can get one-off gifts and individual boxes. But if you do want to subscribe, you should use my special URL, which is kiwico.com/Steve Mould. That'll get you 30% off your first month of any Kiwi Crate line. The link is also in the description, so check out KiwiCo today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit subscribe. And the algorithm thinks you'll enjoy this video next.